Hey guys, my name is Eric Rodriguez. I am the student support specialist for Adobe at the University of Arizona. And today I'll be going over how to create some cool effects and manipulations with text in Adobe Illustrator. So to get started, we're gonna bring up the title tool by clicking T on the keyboard. And we're going to click anywhere and we can just write out a word or two. Let's just go ahead and write Adobe. We're gonna click off. We're going to click V for the selection tool. We're going to select it and we're going to hold shift. Just make this bigger so it's easier to work with. So to change our font, we're going to select the text and go over to the right underneath character. We're going to open this drop down menu and select this font right here. Now, once we have our font selected, we're going to go ahead up to type. We're going to scroll down and we're going to hit create outlines. Now what this does is that it's taken the text that we wrote out and it's created vectors using it. So we're just gonna go ahead and ungroup. And as you can see, we can now click on these and select them individually without the whole word being selected. And now what happens with this is that these letters behave like vectors or shapes. And so that we can use different tools such as the direct select tool to kind of make some cool effects with them. Now, for example, if we hit A on the keyboard to use the drag selection tool, we can go ahead and select two of these corners. We're gonna click the first one, then hold shift and click the second one. And now we can actually manipulate this edge so we can extend it out a bit if we'd like. We can just kind of play around with it. And so let's make it go up like this. We can do this with any of the letters. So let's, for example, take the E here. We'll extend this out as well, clicking the first corner, holding shift, and clicking the second one again, stretching it out. What we can do now is just build some shapes and connect them with the shape builder tool. And we can actually just connect this part of the E over here to the extension on the B. So to do that, we're gonna go ahead and take the ellipse tool. It can be found over here or just by clicking L as the shortcut. And we're just gonna make a circle. And to get a perfect circle, which is what we'd like for this, is we're gonna hold shift and drag that out. And as you can see, as it scales up or down, it's a perfect circle all around. So we're just gonna go ahead and make our circle. We're gonna click V for the selection tool. And we're gonna go ahead and position that so that it just kind of overlaps on both of these intersections here, on the E and on the B. So let's lower the opacity just so this is a little bit easier to work with and we can see what's in the background. We'll change it down to somewhere around 50. Sweet. So now we can just take this corner, extend it out holding shift, and we're gonna try and make these line up a little nice. Now that we're happy with the placement on here, we're actually gonna go ahead and select it, then option, click, and drag to create a duplicate. And we're gonna just make another one, scale it down just a little bit, and go ahead and place it right back on top of the other one. As you can see, we now have two circles stacked on top of each other. And what we're gonna want is we just want this arc right here. So we're gonna go ahead and select both of these circles, select the first one, hold shift, and select the other one. And we're gonna go over to the side here and select the Shape Builder tool. Or we can, the shortcut for that would be Shift and M. And now what we can do is go ahead and remove parts that we don't wanna be in here. So in this case, it'd be the inner circle. So to remove that, we're gonna go ahead and hold Option. You'll see that the cursor changes to a minus symbol. And we're just gonna click on the inner circle. So now we have a nice ring around our letters, but let's say that we only want this arc here. We want to get rid of everything else except for this little arc. So to do that, we can go ahead and look for the intersections where the arc is. So in this case, it'd be right where the E is and right where the B is, these little extensions we kind of made. We're going to select the ring, and we're also going to select the E and the B by holding shift and clicking once again. And now we're going to go ahead and use the Shape Builder tool once more. And what we're gonna do now is get rid of the areas of the ring that we don't want. So holding option once again, we're gonna go ahead and remove this portion of the ring, just like so. And just like that, we have the arc built out. So now, as you can see, this isn't entirely perfect. We kind of have an edge sticking out here. So we're just gonna go ahead and select these once more and use the Shape Builder tool again. And we're gonna zoom in here and just get rid of these imperfections. So now that we're done with that, we're going to go ahead and select the ring again and bring up the opacity. Just go ahead and turn it back up to 100. Now let's say that we want to create this arc and reciprocate it over here. And we want to actually pull down part of the D and do that. So as you can see, there isn't really a corner here we can grab onto. But if we hit M and draw out a rectangle, we can now go ahead and actually, using the direct selection tool, select the corners of that rectangle, and we can simply pull that out. Now, since we made a rectangle and extended that, that isn't actually part of the letter, but to change that, we can just go ahead and select both of them and use the Shape Builder tool once again. And as you can see, it'll show up all the different intersections and pieces making up this letter. And if we just click and select all of them, it'll go ahead and combine it for us. But let's say we want to change the colors on this logo. We can actually just go ahead and select all the parts that we'd like to change at once by shift clicking. And we're going to go over to fill. And as you can see, we can just go ahead and bring up any color we'd like. And now for this side, I'll go ahead and use blue. And now what we can do with the O actually is to make it transition nicely from the red to the blue is we can actually go in here and make the O a gradient color with red being on the left side and blue on the right side. So to do that, we're going to select the O and go ahead and select the gradient tool or hit G on the keyboard and just click on the O. So as you can see, it went ahead and made the O a gradient from white to black, which is nice, but not exactly what we want here. So to change that, we're going to go ahead and select the O, make sure we're in the Properties tab, and go down to Fill. From Fill, we're going to click on Gradient Options, and it'll bring up this window. So making sure that we have the O selected, we're going to hit I to bring up the Eyedropper tool, and we're going to go ahead and select this red from the A and the D. And now that it's on here, we can go down and drag it onto the white portion. Now we're going to do the same thing with the blue. We're going to select the blue, except that this time we're going to drag it onto the black portion. And as you can see, what that does is it'll actually make this gradient transition from red over into blue. Thanks for watching our tutorial. For more Adobe content tutorials, be sure to head over to adobe.arizona.edu.